There's probably not a lot of talking gonna happen in this one. Just cuz, how are we doing here for, there we go, real hole. There. Isn't that wonderful? Oh no, they got me again, those guys. You can't win. Even when you're winning, you can't win. Okay. If anybody hasn't guessed yet, it's getting new frets. So we
surmise.
Okay. So, I got my 7.25 radius block with some 220 grit paper on there. Right now, the truss rod is relaxed. The neck is very straight. Just want to try and take out a few little inconsistencies in this guy. Because we want the frets to lay flat. Nice. We can see at some point in time someone was playing tricks and used some sort of colorant or a dye or a stain or something on these or on the fretboard. Anyway, a little bit of oil, she matches right back up. Make sure we get all that off of there. And next, on my list of things to do, is to check all the fret slots and make sure they're deep enough. Something nasty happened there. There's a big abrasion across the fretboard there. Not quite sure why, but anyway, yeah, so somebody put something on here at some point in time to darken this up or whatever they did. I don't know. Now I got it on me. So, look, one at a time, I'm probably just gonna pass the fret saw through these once. And only once, because we don't have a lot of big fretboard there. These are just, we really want to make sure that the fret goes all the way down in the slot. That one, why am I feeling resistance there? Is there a paper towel or something stuck in there? Anyway, yeah. Okay, I'm putting this aside and we're gonna roll some wire. I'm way over here. What could go wrong? So, radius gauge and start very gently. Okay, be like that. Once I get it set, then I'll be able to roll the other pieces of wire quite easily. Let's just try that for the first try. You'll see in a second.
Okay, so I haven't rolled any wire in a long time, but that, my friends, is a real excellent guess. I just wanted it a little bit tighter than 7.25, and I'm gonna roll with that. Okay, so in it goes, and everybody's gonna ask me, Dave, where'd you get that bender, that roller? And I got this off a guy a long, long time ago. And I'm pretty sure he was in the Ottawa Valley Canuckusland thing. It was like a eBay thing. And he also made a a fret end beveler that I will use as well in this job. Three pieces of fret wire. We're on our way, folks. We're on our way. Okay, we're gonna cut some wire. One thing I didn't show when I was prepping the neck is I take a tiny triangular file and put a little chamfer on each side of the fret slot. That way, I know that the fret wire is going to sit in there nice. Back to the radius, a little tighter than what's going to fit across the fretboard. And I got some tape set up over here. And I am going to cut some wires. And I like to leave about 3/16 of an inch on either side. There's my first fret. And we're going to go and continue on and on and on.
You can't see them. They're over there. One wonderful pieces of fret wire. And that's the first one. It's gonna get tapped in right there. And let's get tapping. Hold on, I need the tapper. I thought I was all prepared. Look at that. I'm in really no hurry to complete this task, and I want these frets to stay put. So it's a little there, a little there, and tap the rest home. That's it. Keep on going. And as with most refrets, there's always going to be one or two problem frets. So I got this guy here, he's going to have a little glue, because it don't want to grab. And one other one, I think, I'm going to have a good look-see, just to make sure. Another one here. Yeah, it's down. Optical illusions. That's the worst one so far. There's another little guy there. But hey, the other thing that happens is after 50 years, the oil from your skin gets underneath the frets over time, and that, yeah, see all these guys here, and it's always on the side where your hand is, because that's the most wear on the fretboard. There's a lot of spots on this which were almost scalloped. That one's really the worst one of the bunch, but yeah, we'll check them all. And just because of the age of the guitar, I might there's a little trick to actually glue every fret end, especially on a guitar like this, which I am going to incorporate. That one's good. Last one. So now I will use the radius block to make sure that these are fully seated, especially at the edges, and then I'm going to take a pipette and put a tiny drop of CA glue right down every one of those, and that should do it on both sides. Like I said, because it's a refret and the fretboard is so thin, that's one of the reasons I'm getting a little bit of issue at the edge, and that's just part of the way she goes, but it's going to be nice, folks, you'll see. Okay. That's that. Now we trim, and it's important to know where every one of those little suckers goes. And that one, I felt it hit my shoe. And it's gone. You bastards. Why is it important to know where those go? Because they'll come back to haunt you, bite you, and mess you over later on. And if you get good, you know right where to put your hand, where it is. Plank catch. Okay. Now we trimmed. Actually, I could get rid of a few tools here. Let's get rid of a couple things I'm not using, and then it'll be like a professional. Yeah, so now, beveling the edges. Got this guy, made by the same dude that made the bender. And I wish I could find him, because this is a really good one. It's nice and long. Then you got this one that they want an arm and a leg for that only does one side. As you can see, this will do. See, the problem is, let's just see here. I may not be able to do it. Once again, it's all about the clearance. Yeah. We'll get there. And then there's this little guy from Crimson. But anyway, this one makes quick work of things. And before I do the end ends, we'll do the bevel end. the angle first. Okay, so at this point, I'm just working on all the fine-tuning, shaping the fret ends. And I'll be sitting here for about an hour. It's really a good time to just put on some tunes. You know, maybe make a coffee or whatever you're having. And get all artistic. So once I get the shapes all done, there's a few little spots where I had some chip out, and I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna hopefully make that all disappear too. Okay, stay tuned, more to come. Tribute to J. Geils Day today, folks. One of my all-time heroes, the J. Geils Band. Okay, so I have in this cup some rosewood dust. And now we have some white glue and some toothpicks. So what will happen is we are going to, yeah, I can zoom in a little bit. I don't know if it'll show up in the movie or not. There's a little chip out there. I'm not sure what happened here. As careful as I was, a little bit of chip out there. So we're going to put a little bit of white glue in that defect and then offer up some rosewood dust in there. And who knew? Oh, and there's one other little spot where some CA glue got on here, and I'll take a little acetone and clean that off. And a tiny little spot there too, I think. So that's what's next, and then I'll probably quit to let all that dry. Then we will be taping off, leveling, crowning, polishing. Because even though they're new frets, so just to be clear, that this is your $150 fret job. There you go. Done. I quit. No leveling, no crowning, no nothing. And then after that's done, we can put the guitar back or together. And then we're going to make a new nut, because that's another thing that everybody forgets about when they get new frets, is that the nut is probably not going to be right. How could it be? Think about it for a minute. So that's that. So a little bit scary. I pooped my pants a couple times, but that's the fun. Would you look at the big, juicy, blue son of a bitch I found. Okay, we're here. 1,000 grit. You guys have seen all this shit before. I don't know, can you say shit on YouTube anymore? We don't know. Look at that. Just having fun yet? I'm having a great time. Well, not a great time. J. Geils passed away. 71 years old. Not a hell of a lot older than me. All those shows, shit, I love those guys. Seems like they played in Detroit every week. Not really every week, but probably it was the time in my youth where they played every 6 months. and we go. I can remember bringing one girlfriend that I had at the time. And she had never seen Jay Giles. And I said, well, you know what? We're going to see the best band in the world. Best rock and roll fucking band in the world. And she laughed at me. She thought I was nuts. Really? How could they be the best band in the world? Well, once the night was over, she was converted. Yes, we are going all the way, honey. 2000 grit, you won't feel a thing. And we'll just slide right in. You'll see. Well, the thing about Jay Giles is, and the Jay Giles band is, went beyond a band. It was an experience and a fun time, and you know, 13 times I saw that band over the years. I watched them grow up. You could just tell. You just went, wow, these guys are so good. Everybody should know. Shit, I'm sorry. I'm sad.
Fuck. Okay, so we're at that point in the program where it's the big reveal. Just that sound makes my bum tighten up. I don't know what it is about that. Something about that. Anyway. Okay, stopping now before the big reveal. I just want to thank, first of all my subscribers. You guys make it rock. On top of that, all my patrons. Yeah, I know everybody gets pissed off about that, but you don't get it. In the near recognizable future, everything's going to be pay-per-view, and you know, if you don't like the ads, see, that's the gag. If you don't like the advertisements, then you must pay a fee to get out of them. Anyway, thanks to all my patrons. You guys really make it tick. I hope you notice I've been just like kicking out the videos. Yeah, okay, so you remember the person that said, oh, just put a piece of tape all along the side.
Yeah.
In theory, guys. I like peeling tape. I'm not in a hurry. This isn't an assembly line or anything, guys. And girls. I think I banished all the girls. They got all bitchy. And see there, I put the tape on the edge and I peeled it up. And what happened? What happened? Same thing that would have happened if I had just not done that, you know. It's the way it is. Everything has to get done twice, even three times, to get it right. Because we didn't have time to do it right in the first place, but now we've suddenly found time to do it again. Back to what I was blabbing on about. Yeah, just put a piece of tape along the edge. And it'll all come off. Yes, it's time to quit. That's a 1966 Fender Stratocaster neck with
all new fret things in it. And I guess I'll do another part. Put it back together, and we have to make a new nut machine for it. But anyway, cheers, folks. Thanks to everybody. Last but not least, get a sticker. Because if you get a sticker, part of the sticker fund goes to the War Amps, and I'm happy to be able to do that. Day's World of Fun Stuff, sticker, War Amps, charity, support my channel, support a really good cause, and fix your shitty guitar, or not so shitty guitar. What is a 1966 Fender Stratocaster worth? I'm a scared to ask, but I'm proud to be able to bang new frets into it. Yeah, man. Cheers.